Hello, Nader here. Welcome back to Path of Exile. We're playing in the Hardcore Legacy League as a solo self-found Jedi. We use Ice Shot to freeze things. And today, we are going to run in the Primordial Pool. We have a nice Nemesis mod on here. And monsters take reduced extra damage from crits. I think that's going to be lovely. Oh, before I forget, let's pop in some legacy stones. We're gonna run Nemesis, so it seems fitting to also pop in Bloodlines. Get a lot of magic mobs, got a lot of rare mobs. Just have a lot of fun there. We are still hunting for Rogue Exiles, so they go in. And if we're gonna get a lot of special things, might as well to get some warbands, just to up the ante a little bit more. And with that, let's get going. Into the Primordial Pool. The end boss is gonna be Malakai. Well, it's gonna be Maps Malakai. That's just not to be confused with Merciless Malakai or Core Malakai. Those are both a bit more difficult. Was that actually the way forward? That was the way forward. Ooh. Going up in the world rather than down. Most of the time, when I have to play this map, I have to go down to proceed rather than up. So suddenly my whole world is upside down. Ooh, Volatile Stormblood Reflector. Let's stay out of its way. And let's not get hit, as usual. Ooh, another Reflector. Well, still, we shouldn't be able to kill ourselves with Reflect, so it's good. If we're ever gonna do a Reflect map, that is where Reflect rares are gonna be very dangerous. But, well, regular maps, we just don't have the damage overkill just yet, which is good. Yeah, let's actually take a step backwards here. Blink Arrow. Let's get into the habit of using Blink Arrow. So, big news in Path of Exile. We finally have a, well, tentative date for the beta. So, the Legacy League is scheduled to end on Monday, the 29th of May 2017. So, that is 18 days after this video goes live. So, that means there's going to be 18 more episodes in this daily series, of course. And at my current rate, I tend to play about 3 maps per map tier. Also, let me lower the volume a little bit. I play about 3 maps per map tier. So that means that we're gonna make it to about tier 11 if we do daily series. And I know that once I hit tier 8, tier 9, It gets progressively harder to advance, because there's just going to be a lot more map farming to actually keep my mapping pool up, to get lucky enough with the map drops and all those things. Especially with the yellow maps, I don't instantly want to do a rare yellow map and just get murderized. I want to do it as a blue one first and then do the yellow one, just to ease into it a little bit. Oh, hello there, Zana. So it is very possible that our progress is actually going to slow down a little bit towards the end rather than accelerate. So if we're still alive by the end of the league, the last weekend before the end might be a very good weekend to do a final stream or something, or multiple streams just during the weekend, and see just how far we can push into the endgame content. But for now, just gonna focus on just cruising through and seeing how far we can make it. Let's clear a little bit around Zana and then actually do the Zana mission. I thought I had cleared everything, but... And that eye thing popped up. Hello there, Flamebearers. Beset by Hybermen. Well, yeah, I think I was talking about the end of the league. That was the 29th. And then on Wednesday, the 7th of June, The beta is gonna start. At least that's the current tentative date. And the devs expect the beta to last 5 to 6 weeks. So if everything goes according to the plan as the devs have it right now, that would put the launch in late August or early September. Which I suppose is not a bad time, because then most people will probably be back from vacation, things like that. Because, well, launching a new expansion when everybody's on vacation might not be the best plan from a commercial point of view. Let's actually leave that one the B, and let's go back to Zana. I haven't picked up a lot, so we can just dive in. Complete another master's mission in the Arachnid tomb. Okay.
They feel your every move, your every breath. With a million little wires.
Tier 5 equivalent. Twinned bosses. Bosses deal extra damage and attack faster. So that's going to be interesting. It's spider area. So, and we're going to get Verici. Let's see what Verici wants from us. Also the admittance tiers, or the admittance conditions, I should probably say, for the beta have been stated as well. If you spend, I think it was $450 or $500, something in that order of magnitude. So basically, if you have bought a max tier supporter pack somewhere in the past, then you are in. If you have bought cumulative amounts equal to that, then you're in as well. Then you just know your account will then just be flagged for beta. And if you buy any of the supported tiers that will come with the Fall of Oriath, then a beta key will be included as well. So now if you spent a lot of money in the past, then no, you're in. If you haven't, then by presumably spending not a lot of money, you can get into the beta as well. And in some Q&A, Bex also clarified, the community manager, she also clarified that your account will be flagged for the beta if you have spent the required amount prior to the beta starting. But if you buy a supporter pack, that's actually going to include a key. So if you have your key, if you have your account flagged for the beta, but then also buy one of the new supporter packs, you're basically going to have a spare beta key that you can give to someone else. So that might be an interesting opportunity to just get one of your friends that's not playing the game into the game, or something along those lines. So yeah, very much looking forward to it. From what I understand, content included in the beta will be Acts 1 through 8. Act 9 and 10 are not going to be in the beta. Which is similar to the Awakening expansion, which added Act 4 to the game. Because then I think the Malakai fight and the entire Belly of the Beast wasn't in the beta either until like 1 or 2 days for the end of the beta or something. So they're trying to keep something of the beta a surprise, so that the Fall of Oriath will... It will be new to everybody, at least some parts will be new. And it's also just going to be effectively just standard or hardcore equivalent. There's not going to be a challenge league or anything running inside of the beta. It's just going to be the base game. Which, of course, it's good, because we're there to play the base game. Any challenge league that's going to launch alongside of it, when it does go live, that's going to be bonus new content. And if you're not going to be in the beta, the devs did also announce that, or they hinted, they actually haven't released any details yet. They hinted that we will be getting lots and lots of events. They're going to run lots of events, so many events. So yeah, we'll just have to see what that's going to be. I'm of course going to play the beta. It's interesting that they're choosing to launch on a Wednesday, so that's the middle of the working week. I'll have to see how I can jiggle my schedule whether I can free up some space to just do a lot of streaming when the beta starts, or whether I'm gonna have to wait until the weekend or until the Friday or something. Slay the guards, keep the target alive. Okay, so sure, let's just use lots of frenzy here. Also, let's not get cursed too much. Okay, there is the or a green gate. Okay, that's okay. Archer, it's gonna stay at a distance. That's good. Of course, but for each missions, in this case, the most dangerous of the foes, we have to leave them alone. But unfortunately for them, killing them is gonna be enough. That actually fit. Nice. And Vorici is a happy ducky. Hey, then it's time to move forward and see if we can deal with two bosses at the same time. Hello, goodbye. So yeah, more details about the beta are probably gonna come in the nearby future. And no, the more firm and the more solid the dates get, the more I will know about my own plans. Yeah, we can still go for it. Once we got really full, we'll just portal out, because we have multiple portals here. And now it's basically gonna be a challenge to keep my character alive for the next 2.5 weeks. Until the end of the league. Wow. Now, if I'm looking at how things aren't going so far, I think... Oh, if I just keep not doing too many crazy things. And yeah, we might actually make it to red maps. Because so far it's going pretty good. The damage output of this character is well higher than any of my previous characters so far. No survivability, it's... Well, it's not a tank, but then again, it's not supposed to be a tank. And instead, we do get a lot of extra damage. It's just going to be the boss fight where we're going to be locked into a very tiny room with a very, very angry boss. Those might not be the maps I really want to go for all too much. And instead, no, just see if I can focus more on the maps where the boss fights are going to be slightly more favorable. On the other hand, of course, we do have a lot of life leech. We do it all of damage. We've got foul pact, so we've got instant leech. So as long as we keep dealing in damage, well, get out. No devourers allowed. But yeah, as long as we keep doing decent damage, then we should be able to just leech tank to a certain degree. I'm not entirely sure if that's going to be the wisest of that is, but some boss fights might just require that. Or, oh, really honing in on that freezing and doing hit and run until we freeze the boss, and then see if we can just keep chaining it, keep the freeze up. Also, there are a couple more rooms left in this area, so let's actually clear those. Let's not waste any XP. We started off at level 80. We are getting pretty close to level 81 now, which is nice. Also, we might have missed a couple of mobs, or all 31 bonus mobs are going to be in the boss arena. So this is going to be double spider bosses, I would say. Yeah, well, whatever. Well, we'll look at loot in the fight. So we have ourselves a golem, we have ourselves a vile trap, we have ourselves a decoy totem, and we just have to move around a lot. So let's do this. Wasn't wrong about this add-on bit. Yeah. Okay, so there we are. Two bosses, and indeed. Okay, we're being slowed quite a bit. Okay. One's down. Two are down. And that one is dead as well. And we got a Baroque round shield. I don't recognize these graphics. What is it? Duresso's Courage. That's pretty neat. Increased chance to block, that's always nice. Chance to block attacks if you've blocked a spell recently. 20% chance to block spells if you've blocked an attack recently. So, of course, if you're being attacked by something that does both spell and attacks, this is gonna set yourself up with a nice block generator. Because of course your base chance is going to be just a 28% chance to block attacks. That's what it always does. So if you block an attack, that gets you 20% spell block. If you then use that 20% spell block to block an attack, then in turn that's going to trigger the other one. If you play this on a gladiator that focuses on the spell block chance is equal to the block chance, then you're going to get spell block out of the gate. So if the spell block triggers, that's going to fuel your block, which is instantly also going to get transferred into spell block. So this has a very strong synergy. So that might actually be pretty darn cool. 100%, 20% job of block chance applied to spells, but on low life. So if you're playing this on a specific low life build, then you get spell block out of the gate as well. This probably has a lot of interesting build around potential. Let's just do one loot run. And then... Oh god, no. Disconnected from the server, failed to join any instances, seriously. Game? Why? Okay. So, we might have just completely lost this one. Let's see, if we go back to the character selection. Let me just go back. That is one of the downsides of... let's actually type it correctly. One of the downsides of an always online game, of course. Seriously, we lost our map. So, yeah, game instance crashed. No map. On the other hand, let's count this as a virtual victory. We fought a double spider boss inside of the Arachnid tomb. Okay, tier 5, it was slightly downgraded from its normal tier 7 or tier 8. But we played it, it was a Zana instance, and well, we actually got our loot as well. So we did not clear the primordial pool. I will have to find myself another one of these maps and run it to actually clear that one. So we did burn a the legacy stones and things like that, but well, white maps are replaceable. I'm at least happy that we completed the Zana mission. That was a nice challenge by itself. I got to talk about the beta at the end of the league, so it was a good episode. I'm slightly disappointed we didn't get to complete it, but well, that's those things happen. So for now, I'm gonna thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you again next time, and hopefully that map won't crash. Bye bye.